So we do have a special guest in the house, Shruvano, who is an Afropop singer, songwriter, and performer. He's known for his deep lyrical content and strong vocal delivery. Born Valentino Otuya on the 14th of February, which is Valentine's Day, 1994 in Kano, Nigeria, Shruvano obtained a Bachelor's of Arts degree from the University of Benin, where he studied English and Literature. The spiritual Murano, or Tiny Boy of Africa, as he is fondly called, released his first studio single in 2018 with the title Eba, featuring ace rapper Eriga and Kenti. Later in February 2019, he made Smile with Tenny the Entertainer. He's most famous for his recent single Guaranteed Day, released in February 2020. Please welcome with me, Shruvano. Hi.
Welcome.
How's it going?
It's good, man.
I'm great.
Alrighty, it's good to have you on the show. So I don't know, you've been watching.
Yes.
Before we even start diving into you and your music and your career, let's talk about the last conversation that we were having, which is the hot topic of the day, having five friends for 5 years. Mm. Do you have such a thing? What's that like for you?
Well, I am not really a group person, yeah. Mm. I think it's quite a lot to have five friends for 5 years. Mm. It takes a lot because there's going to be truncations, communication breaches and all. So it's not really my thing, but I have people that have been my friends for over 5 years and we still keep in touch, even if not like as regulars, you know, but each time we hit each other up, it's always, you know, I have people like that. But having like a group of people that know themselves as well, no, I don't think
I want to ask you, because you're in the entertainment industry and you're a performer, and I think there is always a bridging gap communication when somebody blues, if I can put it that way. Mm. So a lot of the times, people who know you, like when you were, let me say a nobody, not on TV or whatever, not having that vibe, yeah. You were a lot more accessible and things. Obviously, life would change and your situation would change. Mm. Can you give me a personal experience of that? Like how you've either lost friends or how you've managed communicating to them that, oh, I still do, or maybe you just, you're okay with moving on because you're not in a different phase of life?
This is quite timely because I had this kind of conversation with someone just yesterday.
Oh, wow.
Now,
okay.
The thing is, the first thing is perception. Mm. It's already a general thing. People feel like when you're already there, you don't care about a lot of people. It's not totally true. Mm. It has to do with personality, right? Like, and it's different with people. So now, first of all is, yes, you get really busy and unavailable as you used to be, right? So, but the scare is people just feel like he's not going to respond. So they don't even try to reach out.
Yeah.
Yes, but then some people try to reach out and they're expecting you to respond the way you've always responded. Mm. It cannot be.
Okay.
It can never be. That's the truth. Because before then, there was a time. Mm. You had the time to, you know, communicate in every way possible. Mm. But right now, you have so much in your head. You have so much on your table. So there's not so much of the time anymore. So maybe if they text you and you could reply like promptly, like maybe same day, same moment before. Now it could take you maybe like a day, maybe you're busy and then you have to have specific time to check your socials, you know, and then you have to reply a bit late. It takes only a few people to really understand that, okay, and then they're coping with the new thing. So it's not everybody that has maybe pride or whatever they call it, right? It's not pride. Things have to change.
Okay, let me ask you one last question, because I'm getting my own answer, because this has happened to me several times with friends and stuff. What is stopping you from hanging out with the people that you used to? Obviously, you can't hang out with everybody. I've explained time, but is there any other reason why you'd be like, I can't just hang out with this person anymore?
Well, I would say like at some stages, there are effects people have on you, right, that tends to change with time, right? It's not like you see them less. Now, not everybody really works or grows in the same pace. So sometimes you get to the level where you don't want to be identified with some people no more. Not because you look down on them, but because it might be a bit detrimental.
Right. Yeah.
They might not be growing in the pace you're growing, but you don't want to look down on them. So you just
hold you back.
Yeah, exactly. So you try to like shed it off a bit.
Do you think there's a pressure for you to now have celebrity friends as well?
It's not really about celebrity friends. Yes, it adds to the profile.
It does.
When you begin,
sure
yes.
Does.
But it doesn't mean you should push off the people who've been there, right? There are a few people you can always still pull along.
Now, my question would be, a follow-up to that is, do you think that on that note, the friendship has to be, what are you bringing to the table? Yes, we can all be friends. We may not be growing at the same pace, but can I confide in you? Can you hold my secrets? Or whenever I speak to you, do I feel better? Do you think that there has to be something I'm benefiting from friendship before I can actually call you my friend?
First of all, I think it's dependent on the kind of bond you share with the person. Right? And then no matter how big you get, it's not a yardstick for you to belittle the people that have been there with you from way back. Do you understand? So there could still be the communication. Y'all could still share secrets and stuff, right? But I just feel that giving so much energy is dependent on how special the person is to you. You make efforts to pull your friends along. And then when maybe you notice that the energy is not mutual, they don't want to be carried along, because some people are like that.
Yeah.
And then you just have to, that's it.
I mean, at the end of the day, even celebrity or not, friendship is a very complicated thing. But let's move on a bit from friendship. Thank you for sharing that with us. We're going to play a game really quickly before we go into the interview. Don't worry this time. It's called Two Truths and a Lie. So like the name implies, you would tell us two truths about yourself and add a lie inside in whatever order you want. It's for us now to try and fish out, you know, if what the lie is, if that makes sense. I'll start first, so just so we get a good grip of the game. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so my two truths and a lie. I speak three languages. I am a twin, and I've had surgery before.
Okay, so...
Wait!
Okay, you should go first.
Whoa, so I'm going to pick out the lie.
Yes.
I think... I think you're not a twin.
Okay.
I'm a twin.
You are?
Really?
Okay, so
it's cheating because the friend knows me.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah. So don't worry, I shouldn't play that game with you.
Was that right?
Yes, you.
Oh
were
my
right.
God!
Why? I don't look like a twin.
I just know. I don't know. It was a wild guess.
Okay. Ife, your turn.
Okay, so my turn. I'm single. I'm married with two kids, and I'm a Yoruba boy.
Oh, come on. Let me just tell
you why. Okay, so one more.
I think
I like to party.
Wait, can you run over again?
Yeah.
You like to party?
I like to party. I'm married with two kids. I'm single.
Really?
You're looking at my face. You're looking at my face. Like, which one are you?
I'm picking the lie. I think you're not married with kids.
You're actually really good at this game. Really, really good. You got that correct.
If I
saw you single, I don't understand.
Well, I had two lies.
I'm very confused.
I had two lies in my
head. What is the truth? Are you actually single?
The only truth is I'm a Yoruba boy. The other is the lies.
I think
that's the twist.
I wish Elsie was on this table, because your marital status is...
would have discussed.
It's a bit tricky.
No. I just gave you two lies and one truth.
All right, let's just go into the interview really quickly with you. Thank you so much for playing that game with us. That was fun. Okay, I wanted
to know...
You
didn't get
to
tell us these, though.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh, like,
I'm
I
so
have
sorry.
To
yes.
say
yeah.
my...
Yes, yes, okay, yes, okay. yes.
So, we need to figure out your life.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
This would be hard, because we don't really...
know me?
Yeah, but...
Okay. I attended more than one tertiary institution.
Where?
I have...
Ife, allow the man to do his thing. You didn't... Nobody asked for Jara and Fisi for you.
I have had a surgery, and I have a kid.
You've not had a surgery, that's the lie.
I watched you attempt before I really answer.
You have a kid, a whole child.
It's dicey, yeah.
A whole child.
I'll say you don't have a child.
That's correct.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hey. Alrighty, I want that. Nice. Okay, so we already know one thing about you, that you're not a dad. But tell us about your name. It's not anywhere close to your actual name. Where was that? Where did that come from?
Okay, it's actually from my it's from my actual names. Okay. Like my full names are Chukwuneku Valentino Otuya.
Right.
Oh, so that's Chuvano.
Right. Okay. About your sound. Did you always know that that's the type of music that you'd be singing, or did you try a few things and then land at, you know, your Afrofusion?
And to add to that, a little bird told me that you like to call your music Pizza
Fusion. Afro Pizza.
Afro Pizza. Mm. So tell us about that as well.
Okay, from the onset, I never restricted myself to any genre of music, right? Because I listen wild. Mm. So I always knew my music was going to be a combination of ingredients from all the people I listen to. Yeah, so that's why I now call my style of music Afro Pizza. Because for me, it's something like you reach out for random ingredients and then put it all together to a whole. Mm. So that's what it's. So my music is like a blend of Afro pop, R&B, there's high life in it, there's dancehall in it. So it's a whole lot of fusion.
Okay, what influenced that? I mean, you just said you listen wild. Have you always been like a music head? What were you listening to?
What influenced
all of that? Yeah.
Okay, I listen to artists locally and internationally growing up, right? I listen to a lot of Two-Face. And that's like one particular artist I know I really listen to. I listen to Two-Face, I listen to Celine Dion, I listen to Westlife, you know. And then a lot of other Nigerian artists from P-Square to Timaya to Nice and a whole lot of them.
All right, so I like the fact that you said Afro Pizza, meaning your sound should have different recipes, right? Mm. So we'd just like you to do something real quick, you know, with different, you know, let's just switch up and let's see how you can switch up
freestyle,
things.
Yeah.
Are you saying from what I've already done?
Yeah, anything. If it's a freestyle, if it's something you've done.
When I'm with you, there's this feeling taking over me. Could this be love? I don't know, but I am going crazy. If this be love, I'll be here for you, my magic number. You're my magic number. I'll stop there.
Okay, so it clearly ladies' man type vibes I'm getting from that. Do you practice with your vocals? Do you have a teacher? Like, how serious are you taking this music thing?
Okay, I make music with a band. So I'm not just a recording artist. Mm-hmm. I'm a live performer, right? So I do a lot of musical rehearsals, live musical rehearsals with my band and stuff. So I do. There's a lot I put into it that's outside the studio, you know. Yeah, so, yes.
So since you've been doing music, what would you call your biggest achievement thus far?
I think my most recent single is like my biggest project so far. Because I really did not put in so much as my previous singles, but the result has been way
really
bigger
good,
than,
yeah.
yes. Than
that is quite surprising because I know you have a song with Tenny.
Yes, I do.
And you say you didn't put in so much work working with Tenny. We all
No. You didn't put so much work in
on the recent, like, working
as much
on Guaranteed, as much as I did
more.
On that. Yes.
Okay. So what was it like working with Tenny, though?
It was beautiful. It was amazing because I already had it, like, I already knew I wanted her on the track. So I already recorded my part. And then I had what I wanted her to work on. So when I got across to her, I just told her, okay, this was the song and this was the kind of vibe I wanted you on. And she connected like
was
really
that
quickly.
A personal relationship collaboration or you paid for that?
Well, it was both because I had like, I had to meet management.
Of course, and clearance and all that.
We had like
a vibe.
Yeah, I got through to her through a friend, you know, and that was it.
Just because curiosity kills the cat, would it be appropriate if I ask you how much did you pay?
Just
give us an idea.
I would not want to disclose.
Are we talking about hundreds of naira or millions of naira? Okay, let's just put it like that. Hundreds of naira.
Why I would say that there was the influence of friendship in it. Yeah. Right. So I didn't have to like pay.
Okay. So if I'm Tenny's friend and I want to use my friendship influence,
maybe not now because it's been a while.
Yeah. So would it be hundreds? Should I be looking at hundreds or millions?
If you're her friend. If you're her friend.
Yeah, so yeah, if I have
You should still be looking over a million because Tiny is really big now.
Yeah. Big shout out. Thank
All
you.
All right, okay, please. Not that I care, I don't care about the figures, but I wanted to know if somebody else on the line, and resources wasn't the problem, money wasn't the problem, who else would you be so itchy to work with right now?
Tiwa Savage.
Why?
You
like women. I like
And why?
That's it. People would say, to some extent, I look like a feminist. But the thing is, I like the energy ladies put into work. I mean, it's normal. It's almost normal to say the guys, you know, we could do well in music. But when you see a lady putting energy, it takes a whole lot. For someone like Tiwa Savage, I followed her for some time, and she puts in a lot of energy into it. Do you understand? Having with the personal issues and every other issue surrounding, she still pushes through across the world and stuff. So I respect that a lot. And that's why I identify with a lot of ladies in the industry.
Since you started your journey, what has been the biggest challenge for you?
Well, getting sponsors has always been a problem.
Are you signed to a label or are you indie?
Yeah, I am. I am indie right now.
But
yeah, but I work with a lot of labels. Like I have worked with a couple of labels. Like we have partnerships sometimes. And most recently, I'm working with, I have been working with HMB Entertainment. So that's like, so I'm always, you know, looking out for opportunities, the collaborations, and it's endless.
You never know who's watching right now. So if there was an investor who's willing to put in money into your work right now, like how much are we looking at that you think will like make this whole journey faster and better?
The good thing is right now in the industry, what you put in is what you get. So it's not really about how much is necessary to put out the artist. It's how much you're looking at getting. So the bigger you put in, the bigger your result is going to be.
Let me put it this way. I give you a blank check.
Okay.
How much are you going to write?
Let's take it from 20.
20 million 20 naira million or naira. $20 million?
20 million naira. That's like minimum. Yes.
And what would you do with the first 10 million? Not the full 20. I don't care about the other 10. The first 10 million, what would be the first things, or what would the first things you would do with 10 million?
I'll put it on digital marketing.
I like you. Your head is there, but I want away from figures, please. Ifeoluwa. The growth in the music industry. I mean, we were just celebrating Nigeria being 60 yesterday, actually. And we were analyzing the growth and all that. We can't take away the entertainment industry, especially the music industry. There has been some growth, but I want to know from your perspective, especially as an upcoming artist. And I can tell that you've been, even if you're not an active participant, you've been somewhat participating, listening to the likes of Timaya and Two Faces are all like throwback, our veterans and stuff. So from your perspective, what has that growth looked like?
Well, I would point to one particular sector, and that's the digital structure of the industry. Because before now, artists really, the journey used to be a lot more impossible in the eyes of artists, you know, trying to start up your art and all, because it was totally dependent on marketers. Like if you don't get a marketer at the time, you know, like during the times of Timaya, for example, he would always allude to it. If you don't get a marketer who is totally interested in your job, it was like almost impossible for you. But these days, there are platforms where you could start promoting your art to an extent where you can now attract investors. So I would say for the growth in the Nigerian music industry has really been impressive when it comes to digital marketing. And that's like the platform right now everybody's trying to leverage on.
Okay, so right now somebody's watching, feeling, okay, they feel your style, they like the way you're articulating yourself, but what would you tell them that needs to ginger them to go and actually listen to your song? Like, what are you offering that every other kid on the block isn't?
I'm very realistic. I think that's what a lot of artists don't want to do, because they make people see just the glitz and the glamour. But you don't want to put out the truth out there. Me, I am very realistic. I like my music to reflect who I am. So when you listen to my music, you'll be like, whoa, is this how it is? So when you're preparing yourself for the journey, you have to do it with the right ingredients. Because if you're led on a lie, you could get stranded along the way. Do you understand? Yeah. So one thing I do with my music is I put out the real me. I put out a lot of reality in it.
Now, one thing that has been very consistent in the music industries, or in fact, the entertainment industries, that even you see established acts saying that there's fake love. They don't get enough love. I mean, those are even established people, and they'll tell you that this established guy doesn't show love, this person. So I can imagine what it's like for an upcoming artist. I know you probably have some stories of your most, you know, when you've been around somebody and your experience about the fake love in the industry. Can you share one of those stories with us?
It's everywhere. Like, it's not restricted to any sector. It could come from the people promoting. It could come from the fans. It could come from your colleagues. The thing is, some people have an excuse. Like, some excuse I've heard somehow is people feel like you can't correct some artists, like in quote, like when you're already public, people feel like everything you do is supposed to be perfect. So what they feel like, if they try to correct you, you're going to either rebuke them or not pay attention to it at all. You understand? So people are reluctant to saying the truth. So when you put up a material, for example, they'll be like, oh wow, dope, dope, even when it is crappy. Then for others, it's for personal interest. For the angle of promoters, for example, everybody want chop. So if you're bringing in a material, whether it's good or not, they just want to take their own bid, do what you expect them to do, and that's it. So that's about the fake love. And then in the industry too, we have people clicking and ganging. So if you're not in their clique and in their gang, you're automatically an enemy. So even when they don't even have a good knowledge of your material, your personality, or your brand, they're going to talk down on it because you're not in their gang. Exactly. So these are some
gang? Who are you with? Do you have celebrity friends that you're at least, you know, hiding together in one corner doing your thing? Or are you on your own? Are you solo?
I don't have a gang, right? Okay. I know that everybody I know that everybody is a prospective friend and a prospective enemy, right? So I vibe with people who vibe with me. I don't have a clique. That's it. Yeah. So if you give me a good energy, I return it.
Alrighty. Okay. Well, if we have to wrap up because we're running out of time. If someone wants to follow, like, okay, now you have been convinced. You are lyrical. You're real. All of that stuff. Where can they find you?
On Instagram, it's Truvano Official. One word. Truvano is Chuvano Official. One word. On Twitter, it's just Truvano. On Facebook, it's just Truvano. Practically every other social media is just Truvano.
And you are on all social media, on streaming platforms as well, with your music.